Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you students? I hope you all are fine, safe and secure at your home. Your science teacher is back with new chapter, chapter 8, body movements. Students, we have already studied about our body, different organs of our body, internal organs and as well as external organs and different parts of the body. We have already studied all this, and today we will be studying about body movements. Students, you might have seen all living beings move. You agree with this? Yes, all living beings move. How do they move? How animals move? Some animals, they move from their legs, they walk, and some animals, they crawl. And what about birds? They fly with their wings. Human beings walk with their two legs. And how about snake, snail? They crawl on the ground. Okay, students, now what makes these movements possible? Because of the framework of bones in our body. Well, what do you mean by a framework of bones in our body? This particular framework of our bones in our body is called skeletal system, okay? Skeletal system is made up of so many bones, and these bones, the framework of this bone is called skeleton. And today we'll be studying about different joints in our body, in skeletal system, and different bones in our skeletal system. Okay, students, what do you mean by joints? Where the two bones meet, okay, where the two bones meet and have a joint here is called joints, okay? See here, this is one bone, this is another bone. These two bones joined together here, this is called joints. Here is a joint. Here one bone, here another bone. These two bones are joined together and this is called joint, okay? Is this clear? You might have seen, have you played blocks? You go on joining it and build one castle or, you know, any vehicle. How you do that? You go on joining it, okay? You go on fixing it. Same thing in our body, the bones are joined to each other, okay? They are called joints. So, first we'll study about ball and socket joint. In a certain part of our body, like our shoulders and hip girdles, there is ball and socket joint. It will be when one end of a bone fits into the cavity of another bone, we call it ball and socket joint. Okay, suppose if this is one bone here, the shoulder, one bone here, there will be a ball kind of structure. Okay, this bone, one end of a bone fits into the cavity. The cavity here, cavity fits into the cavity of another bone is called ball and socket joint, socket joints, okay? Usually this joint is found in shoulder and hip girdles. Your shoulder, you can see, I can move my shoulder. See, full hand I can move because there is ball and socket joint over here. This helps in the movement of hand in 360 degree direction. See here, I can move here, move backward, move forward because I have got ball and socket joint, and this helps in movement of hand in 360 degree direction. And next comes pivotal joint. Pivotal joint is found between head and neck, okay, where the skull rests on the top of top vertebra and it's joined to it by pivot joint. Where here, skull rests on the top, here vertebra, and it is joined to it by pivot joint. This is called this joint. This joint is called pivotal joint. Which joint? Here, the skull. Here, the skull, there is a form of, it is in form of cylinder shape. Which shape? Cylinder shape. Skull rests on the top vertebra and is joined to it by pivot joint. And next comes hinge joints. Hinge joint in the sense, there are some joints in our body which can like for example elbow joint, okay, it can move forward and backward. It stops in certain direction. Can I move it back? Can I move it back? No, it cannot be. I can move like this, but this joint is from shoulder here, this particular portion. See, I can bend this. Can I move this backward and bend? No, this is called hinge joint, okay, only back and forth, and it stops at a certain point, but it cannot be taken back and bent like this, okay. This stops in certain direction. Now you see here ball and socket joint, here this rotates in 360 direction, okay. Next comes pivotal joint. Pivotal joint, here you see I can turn my head from here to here, okay, not completely 360 degree. Have you seen any human being who turns his head to 360 degree like this, like I turn my hand? No, those joints are called pivotal joint, which is found in head and neck area here, okay. This is pivotal joint. Here I can turn my head and it stops at a certain direction, and then I can turn it here and it stops at a certain direction. I cannot turn it fully like this. Can you see my face here? No, because it cannot move there. So this joint is called pivotal joint. It is found in the skull and neck area, okay. And this ball and socket joint we find in our shoulders. See, I can turn it into 360 degrees. And next comes hinge joints. Hinge joints are found in elbow. And where else do we find hinge joints? Where we can move forward and backward, but we cannot bend it backward. It stops at a certain point. Next comes fixed joints. There are certain joints in our body which are fixed, like skull, the upper part of our head. Can I open this? Can I turn this? No, I can turn this neck, okay? I can turn the jawline here, but I cannot turn this portion here. These are fixed joints. We cannot turn this or rotate this, okay? But neck can be rotated. This is pivotal joint here, neck area, we have pivotal joint. Here is fixed joint. Is this clear? This part is clear. Ball and socket joint is found in our shoulders. Then pivotal joint is found in the neck and skull area. This area, this is pivotal joint, and hinge joint we find in the elbow, okay. And where else we find? You have to search it. And then fixed joints, where did it is? Here, this portion we find fixed joints. It cannot be rotated. And next comes skeleton. As I told you, skeleton is a framework of bones. So many bones altogether we call it bones, and these are joined together. These are called joints. Human bone has 206 bones. How many bones? 206 bones. The first comes skull. What is the function of a skull? What is the function of skull? Skull protects our brain, okay? This portion is called skull. It protects our brain. And this particular, next comes carpals. What do you mean by carpals? Several small bones are called carpals. Now turn your hand, see the back side of your hand. There are many bones, and even in your fingers there are very small bones. These are called carpals, okay? Small bones are called carpals. Next comes rib cage. A rib cage has 12 bones in each side, okay? Rib cage has 12 bones in each side, and it is structured in the form of box, kind of box. It protects lungs and heart, internal organs, lungs and heart, it protects. And next comes, after rib cage comes backbone. Our backbone, we find backbone at back of the body. Our backbone consists of several small bones, okay? It is a frame of work of very small bones called vertebrae. What is it called? Vertebrae, okay? Several small bones help in bending, moving, okay? It helps us to bend, rotate, okay? Because we have several small bones at our back, and this makes one backbone. Several small bones are called vertebrae, and these several small bones makes one backbone. And next comes shoulder bone. Shoulder bone, this portion here, this portion, this is called shoulder bone, shoulder bone. And next comes pelvic bones. Students, pelvic bones are found below the stomach, okay? Below the stomach, where you sit. How you sit? When you sit, you touch here and sit, you can find some bones there, okay? Those bones here, this portion is called, this portion has pelvic bones. And skull, I already explained you. Cartilage. Students, there are some bones which are very soft, not as hard as a bone. Those are found, touch your ears, not this, below, this is called earlobe. The below portion is called earlobe. The above portion of the ear, or the upper portion of the ear, has got a soft bone. That particular ear thin, I will call it, this particular ear portion is called, has cartilage, in the sense soft bones, that is cartilage. And next comes muscles. Muscles are below the skin and above the bones. We find muscles below the skin and above the bones. Next, I have written contractions of muscles. When we move forward and backward of our hand, we can see that our muscles contract, okay? So students, now we'll study about body movements in animals. So this is a earthworm. Earthworm is also called as farmer's friend. It does not have legs. Instead of legs, it has got bristles. What is that? What it has got? It has got bristles. And how does it move? It moves when the contraction and relaxation of muscles takes place. Okay, how does it move? When the contraction and relaxation of muscles takes place, it moves forward. Then next comes snail. Students, have you seen snail? Snails, the muscles are found in foot. Where the muscles are found in snails? Muscles are found in foot, and this helps in the movement of snail. And next comes snake. Snakes has got long backbone, and the muscles are found in the backbone of a snake. It moves by making curves. While moving, the snake has got loop curves. By that curves, it moves forward. Then comes fish. Have you seen fish? Do you all enjoy eating fish? Yes. How does the fish move in water? Because of its body shape, it is easier for the fish to move in the in water. It has got flat body. It is also called as streamlined body. What do you mean by streamlined? See here, it is narrow, then it widens, okay? Narrow, then it widens, then again it gets narrowed here. This helps in swift movement in water. It is also called tapirs. It has got tapirs, and it also moves by with the help of fins and tail. And next comes cockroach. Cockroach have strong wings with muscle. How does it move? It moves by its legs and also by wings, okay? It can fly. And next comes bird. Have you seen bird? How does the bird move? It moves by flying. It has got strong wings, and also the bones are hollow. The bones of bird is hollow. So students, what did we study today? We studied about body movements and joints. What are the different types of joints? Ball and socket joint, hinge joint, pivotal joint, and fixed joint. We also studied about the framework of bones, that is called skeleton. In skeleton, we studied about skull, upper limb, lower limb, backbone, and carpals. What are carpals? What do you mean by carpals? Small bones are called carpals. And how is backbone made up of? Backbone is made up of small bones called vertebrae. Okay. And next, we studied about muscles and muscles found in animals. Okay. And body movements in animals, how does the earthworm move, how does the snail move, how does the snake move, how does the fish move, how does the cockroach move, and how does the bird move. I hope you all have understood today's chapter. Thank you. Jazakumullahu khairah.